What is up, guys? Argue back again. And so if you didn't watch the first episode there, we just did preseason. We did a couple signings. Right now, I'm actually going to do some scouting because we didn't do that in the first episode. So we'll go into our scouting assignment. We're going to go forwards. Let's see who we got. We're not going to do the OHL. We're going to do the QMJHL for 6 weeks. And I know you guys are good with drafting, so when time comes, I'm going to rely on you guys heavily for that. But, also going to GM here. I think we got a couple levels, couple points. 149, so we don't need medical staff. Injuries are off. Provides with in-game injuries, don't need that. Top prospects. And we'll go this one. We'll do the amateur scout. So we're going to do the first 10 games, see where we're standing, see how Ovi's doing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We'll see how Ovi's doing. If he's not putting up some good numbers or reasonable numbers for the first 10 games, we're going to trade him and get some more depth on our team, especially if our team's losing. So we started off with an OT loss, which I guess is decent. Ooh. Landeskog and Sagan are leading the Kings, and they were 2-0, and we beat them 3-0. Huge for us. Now we got two back-to-back games. We got San Jose and Anaheim. Can we get at least a win? Oh, a 4-0 win. There we go. Elliot standing huge. Can he get another shutout? Oh, 3-4 loss. Not too bad. It was in overtime. So he's got two wins, two shutouts already. Our team's getting leaded with 3 goals by Morgan Riley there. Ryan O'Reilly and Nyquist with 3 assists. Got another game. Oh, damn. They were 2-0, then they went 2-2, and then they ended up beating us 4-2. 2-1-2. We need a win here. I don't want to go 2-2-2. Let's get a win. Calgary, another loss. 5-3. We're 6 games in. Ovi's got 4 goals. 3-1-1. Tampa Bay Lightning. This is a win. There we go. 1-0. 3 shutouts. Every game Elliott's won, he's got a shutout. And I don't know what to think about that. Maybe if we trade Ovi, we go for a tender. Who knows? We'll see when time comes. We're at 7 games right now. Okay, 2-5-1 Colorado. Let's get an easy win. Eberle and Henrique leading the team. And we got a 3-2 win. Kind of close, but we pulled it off. Ryan Jones is leading their team in goals. They're not... what? Ryan Jones leads their team in goals and they end up scoring 4 on us? That is not acceptable. Oh, man. 6 goals, Jiří Hudler. And what? Did we get a loss there? I think we did. 4-4-2. So at the end of 10, we're 4-4-2. Let's see where we're standing in the West. We're not in a playoff spot. Well, we're 1 point out. Points. Let's see. Goals, we got no one on there. Assists, we got no one on there. Points, we got no one on there. So, let's see how the team's doing. Stat Central, player stats season, NHL. Played 10 games, Ovi's got 5 goals. That's decent, but he's better have more points. He's got 8 points in 10 games, not too bad. Jager, thank God we picked him up. He's second on the team. Taylor Hall really needs to pick up the slack, only has 4 points. Nyquist has 4 points. Okay, we'll do another 10. We'll see where we're standing, and then we'll maybe make some trades. So, 3. There's 3 here. 6. There's 3 here. 9. And 10. Elliott's got 4 wins and 3 shutouts, so he's probably leading in one category. I don't think many other goalies have 3 shutouts. 4-4-3 in Detroit. West Conference. Let's get a win. And we got a loss in overtime. Ovi's up to 7 goals in 11 games, so he's got both goals that game. Okay, thank God, we got a win over the Washington Capitals. It would be nice to start beating our Western Conference teams, because those are games we really need to win. Ovi got another goal in that 4-2 win. Didn't get a goal in that one, but we got another win. We got another win. Looking good. Ovi and Jager with 8-8. Let's get another one. Yeah, there we go. 9-9. They both gotten a goal and an assist at least. Panthers 8-4-3 with Getzlaf and Steen, and we get another win. Now we're pulling in some wins. This is what I like to see. Ovi's got 10 goals in 17 games. He's on like a 3-4 game streak right now. Yeah, it better be a good year for rookies. Jamie Benn and Andrew Ladd lead the Dallas Stars, and we get another shutout. Huge. Huge. Where do we want to scout? We scouted the Q, right? That's what we did last time with Jonathan Drouin. There he is. We're going to go 6 weeks in the dub, UHL. Dylan Rock, Edmonton Oil Kings prospect. Whoops. So, we're at 17 games, 3 games, and that's 10. We went on a nice little streak here. If we lose, I'm blaming it on our scout, because he would have ruined the streak. 14 goals for Ovi. Look at him go. Berglund moved up, took over the assist lead on the team from Jager. 11-4-3. Calgary, 12-4-3. Oh, 15 goals for Ovi. Maybe we won't trade him. He's on fire. Got 15 goals in 19 games, and we get a win there. Nice. Now, let's take a look here. Edmonton moves up to second. Huge. We had 10 points in 10 games before. We played 10 games. We got 19. Huge. Goals, Ovechkin leading the league. That's what I like to see. I gave him an extra week, and he put up the points. Justin Schultz down there, 8th on assists. For Nashville, that's a defenseman, and we could look to picking him up for some future first-round draft picks. Not this year's, but futures. Points, Ovi leads the league with 23, but other than that, we have no one on there. We might have to pick someone up to give him some support. Wins, Elliott's there with the 13, followed by Bryskalov with 11. Elliott with a .941 save percentage, that's what I like to see. And 1.83 goals against. So he's on both categories. Huge week. Let's go take a look at some stats here. See how our team are doing. See how our defense are putting up points. Because I know we're winning right now, so maybe I shouldn't touch anything till we start losing. But 23 down to 17, down to 14. So that's our first line, I believe, right there. So decent. It'd be nice if Berglund had more points, but our centers are lacking, I'm not going to lie. Morgan Rielly, 82, but Keith Yandel put up 9 points in 20 games, that's what I like to see. Alzner, 8, 7, not too bad. Bertuzzi, PRV, both got 6. Vishnovsky, I thought, would be putting in more, but let's just go look at our rookie skater. He's got 5 points. Let's just check all the rookies here. If he's leading the league in rookies or... Ooh, 10 points. Is that what I saw? Wow, Tarasenko's on a... Oh, and Justin Schultz on defense. Tarasenko, 20 points in 20 games. Huberto, 16. Where's the Yak attack? There he is down there. I want to pick up another rookie. I really do. But I thought I could use Ovechkin for it. But the way we're looking at this, Ovi's not going anywhere. His potential for our team is way too high. Let's just take a look at teams that got some high potential players that they want to get out of there. Probably no one, not gonna lie. Whoops. Morgan Rielly, he's gonna be a savage. Mark Scheifele, he's gonna be a savage. I wonder if we do. I wonder if we can get Morgan Rielly. So We got 2 second-rounders of this year. That's a high... Well, that's like the same. I don't know if they'll accept this. No. Both our second rounds. We only really want the... You guys know so much more about drafting. Okay, right now, if you guys are watching this, let me know if I should keep my second rounds for this year. If not, if I should try to get Morgan Riley in a trade. Because he's going to be a hard guy to pick up, but it's definitely worth shooting for, right? See if there's any teams that got high potential players they want to get out of there. Whoops. I don't think there's really going to be anyone that we can pick up. But, let me know if I should keep those second-rounders. If not, let me know if it's worthwhile to trade them away to get like another prospect. Man, look at Crosby, just a savage. The Nuge, Ryan Murray. Yeah, so I'm going to end that episode here. Both episodes seem to be 12 minutes long. But yeah, let me know if you guys got any feedback. Hit me up. Thanks for watching. It's been our